It's very important that we have the flexibility that the Cle Elum Pool Raise provides us.
The Bureau of Reclamation and Washington Department of Ecology, in collaboration with numerous partners, are raising Cle Elum Reservoir by 3 feet, adding 14,600 acre-feet of water to be managed for in-stream flows for salmon and steelhead.
This water will be intended for fish, and so that water right will be held by the tribe for the benefit of that, working with our co-managers.
The water can be used by releasing it at strategic times of the year to provide benefit to salmon and steelhead during their outmigration to the sea. The most limiting factor to salmon and steelhead production in the Yakima Basin is poor outmigration conditions in the spring, especially with the warm water and low in-stream flows during drought conditions.
Access to the cold, clean water that salmon and steelhead need is becoming increasingly limited due to changing hydrologic conditions in the Yakima Basin.
This basin in particular relies on snowpack, and we've seen lately that we're getting less snow, more rain, so having additional storage capability in the basin is very important. The elegant solution that we found was that additional storage could be provided by adding 3 feet to these radial gates that are behind me.
This is the first storage in the Yakima River Basin since 1933, when Cle Elum was built.
Raising the radial gates was completed in 2017. Since then, efforts have turned toward shoreline protection work, which will continue through 2025.
The shoreline measures work to protect people's property by reducing the potential erosion that'll occur due to the additional 3 feet of water, and now those waves are going to hit at a different location on the bank than they did before.
Shoreline protection work will be completed prior to filling the reservoir with additional water, and techniques to protect the shoreline include perched beach, adding compacted fill above the existing reservoir bed. Conventional riprap, placing angular, broken rock against prepared slopes. Rockery wall, stacking large, angular rocks in an interlocking fashion to create a wall. Anchored logs, branches, root wads, or whole trees which are anchored in place to trap and retain sediment and break up wave energy. Log revetment, anchored logs placed perpendicular to the shoreline. And log terraces, rows of anchored logs placed in parallel to the shoreline with cobbles or free-draining gravel behind each row of logs.
And the project will also improve habitat in the nearshore area around Cle Elum Lake, so the newly emerged fry have some habitat to go and feed along the lake shore and escape predators.
So the Cle Elum Pool Raise project is a component of the Yakima Basin Integrated Plan, which is a long-term ecosystem restoration project.
The integrated plan has 7 key elements, all of which are moving forward together to holistically address the basin's needs. The Cle Elum Pool Raise project will work in concert with the Cle Elum Fish Passage project to improve accessibility to habitat for salmon and steelhead.
100 years ago, when they built all the reservoirs in the Yakima, they did not have fish passage on any of these things. And so the Cle Elum Fish Passage project is to help juvenile fish to get out of the basin.
With the Pool Raise project providing additional water for in-stream flows, and the Fish Passage project giving fish a path to travel downstream of the dam, there will be an increase in salmon and steelhead runs in the Yakima Basin.
And so as these fish return, there'll be increased recreational opportunity, commercial harvest, tribal harvest, and those will be economic benefits as well as social, economic, and cultural benefits as well as recreation.
Both Reclamation and Ecology are funding the implementation of the Cle Elum Pool Raise.
And working with all the partners has been really important. And the work with Bureau of Reclamation, with the state of Washington, and, everybody to see this type of thing happen. It's always exciting to see the progress we're making.
The raised reservoir will improve in-stream flows for fish while continuing to provide multiple benefits to the community, including flood control, recreation, and water for irrigation and municipal uses. Together as a community, we can build a future for water, wildlife, and working lands.